Good morning everyone. In the last class we have started new lesson sound and we have written some important points regarding sound. And what is figure 9? It is about anatomy of larynx. So we will see what is it. This is figure 9. So this is larynx. A small tube-like structure is the larynx, and this is the most important point or important part for the production of sound. This is our human mouth. Okay, this is tongue. This is nasopharynx, means nose-related pharynx, and oropharynx means it is related to mouth. Okay, epiglottis. This is a small structure which will help in controlling nose and mouth movements. That means if it is closed to the nose, then mouth mein jo bhi food hai, that will enter into stomach directly. And if it is closed like this, air will enter into lungs. Like that it manages both. Laryngopharynx. Here, laryngopharynx means where larynx is mixing with the pharynx. And the small structure is vocal cords. These only play a major role in the sound production. Next, this is trachea. From where air is carried to the lungs. Esophagus is from where food is carried to the stomach. So, these are the parts in the anatomy of larynx. Larynx is having two muscular ligaments called vocal cords. These are vocal cords. They are stretched across voice box. Voice box is nothing but larynx. Okay. And it leads to a narrow slit between them. Narrow slit. Slit means opening or hole. Ye jo hai thread-like structures. These two are vocal cords. If they are stretching, small hole is created in between, and from this air is entering inside. Due to air, vibrations are produced. Due to vibrations, our voice is coming out, sound is coming out. And if they are not stretched, they will be closed like this. No air enters, no sound comes. Okay, opened vocal cords. This is open vocal cords. This is closed vocal cords. So these two diagrams you draw for today's assignment. Already you have drawn this diagram, no? This diagram you draw. Figure 10A and 10B. Both open vocal cords and closed vocal cords. See here, vocal cords open during breathing to allow air into lungs. From this, the air will be entering inside the lungs. Vocal cords close when we speak. Okay, when we are speaking, air is not entering inside. It is closed and we can speak. The air from lungs presses between them to cause vibration and produce sound. As these two are closed, inside our body already air is there, no? That air will push these vocal cords and causes movement or vibrations. Due to vibrations, sound is produced. This is about how we speak, how sound is produced outside. Okay, so these two diagrams you draw in your notebook for the assignment, and you learn these two diagrams, this one and this one, along with the parts. In exam, we may ask you the diagrams also. Okay, thank you.